Hello everybody and welcome to my new LP, which is this game Rome Total War. If you've been following my Troy Total War videos, you'll know that that game is a mod for this game. This one in particular is my second favourite Total War game after Medieval 2, so it's going to be quite fun this campaign. So let's begin. If you have a look on the right here, I've unlocked all the factions, even the ones you're not meant to play as. That isn't particularly hard to do, just look it up on YouTube or Google. But the faction I've chosen to play as is the Britons. Firstly, because obviously I'm not going to play as the Roman factions, because there's just been too many campaigns of them. Loads of people have done it. But there's been a few Briton ones, but not a long campaign, I don't think. Firstly, they're on an island, so that's pretty good for defence. And secondly, it's a barbarian type faction, so it would be quite fun to play as them. No advice. Let's try hard campaign difficulty, medium battle difficulty, manage all settlements, follow the AI, and no battle time limits. Short campaign? No, we're going to go for the full long campaign, which means you must become the supreme ruler of Rome and control at least 50 provinces. I think what that means basically is control 50 provinces, including Rome itself. So let's begin.
Before my grandfather's grandfather was born, this was our land. These are good places. Our gods live here, in the trees and rivers. They watch over us. We are happy. We hunt. We love. We have families, homes, a good life. But sometimes we must fight. The Romans disturb the gods. They burn the forests. They take what is ours, wives, children, land. The Romans talk of how they will help us and protect us. They put us to sleep with golden promises. When we wake, all we had is gone, stolen. They take our sons and turn them into little Romans. Ha! So we fight to keep what is ours. What must stay ours? There can be no peace. No peace with Romans, men of stone and iron and lies. There can be only war.
Right, there you go. There's a cutscene there. We start in the year 270 BC, which is a long time ago. The Roman Empire didn't even exist back then. It was a republic. And our symbol's a deer. A reindeer or something. Right. Here we go. This is our starting position. We control four provinces. Right. First things first, what I normally do is just go through each settlement and sort out the taxes and that. You know all this information I told you in the Troy Total War thing, and our public order is pretty high, so I can put up the tax to the highest points. And roads, very important. Roads, better for trade. This city is going to be important as we progress through the campaign. I'll tell you why afterwards. These northern provinces aren't going to be as important, but they can produce some income for us. That's good, all our settlements can go to the highest tax rate. Firstly, I'm going to move this army, which is our factionaire. Say his name, Bellinus. Can go in this city and garrison it. And we've got a diplomat here, which we're going to send down south to the Gauls, which is another faction in this game. And our first target is going to be this island here, which is actually island itself. I think there's one settlement on it. So we're going to have to build up an army. We have one ship, so not much. Take him around here, prepare ourselves the army. This can be the guy who can head over there, but that's not enough troops for a start. We're going to need more troops than that, so we're going to need all of these troops. And now we have a yellow face. Let's put that down. Let's build ourselves some more troops. There you go, all right now. Troops from here. Yeah, we'll have some missile units, I think. And troops from here. I'll leave the peasants in charge. There you go. That should be a big enough army, I think. Oh, we can see the city now. Tara. Oh, good quality units. Although they're... I mean, the unit itself's rubbish, but they have good experience. Unlike my units. Although this guy has one experience, these druids. Right, I think that's everything that we can do for the first turn. Right, the factions that are beside us are... We have Gaul here, sort of like France, and then we have Germany. Either one of them or both of them are going to declare war on us. So we are going to have to prepare for that. That's why I brought the army in, have a large garrison in here. That's a waste of time, having that there. Instead, have a unit of them. So that's the end for the that is the end of the first turn. So let's see what happens. And that rebel army's just moved out some troops. Alright, let's put the spy in there. Let's join these troops up. Oh, almost there. Right. Next turn, obviously. We lost money because we were building loads of stuff. Alright, recruitment. We need to gain lots more money. And a port will be one thing that will help us. The next town. Land clearance farming. There we can have... A good way to check how much money you'll make is by going onto this tab. Yeah, probably land clearance is best there. And land clearance is best there. No, we have barely any money at all. Right, so let's see if we can find the Gauls. Here's their capital, Alesia. A big battle happened there between the Romans, who were headed by Julius Caesar, and the Gauls, headed by Vercingetorix, I think it was. Right, map information, no, trade rights, map information for map information. They accept, so we'll be getting a little bit of trade now from them. And as you can see, the Gauls' land is sort of spread out here. We have some land in Spain, quite a lot of land in France, and then some in what will become Northern Italy. God, trouble with my words here. Right, I think that's everything again. These first turns are going to be quick. Right, this first episode, probably between 20 and 30 minutes long, just one episode today, just to get you into it. I don't know what I'm going to do for the future ones. Right, we have a little bit of money, but every place is building at the moment. Right, Germany. I'm going to try and get an alliance with them. Want an alliance with someone. They accept. That's good. So hopefully Germany won't attack us. It'll be Gaul that attack us. And as you can see, Germany have quite a bit of land where Germany would be, basically. Right. That's one big army, really, for a start. Right, next turn we'll go across the sea and attack Tara. Again, that is the end of the turn. Oh, let's have a look at the tab for a minute. Right, financially we're going to make a little bit of money. We have one ally. What about our family members? Our king. He has three sons. And we have some family members coming soon. They're still children at the moment. Okay. Actually, one thing I want to do. Take out my leader and build towers in places. I hate not being able to see my territory. All this, like, fog of war. I want to see my territory. Only cost 200 gold for a tower. So it's worth it, in my opinion. (Clears throat) Right. Yeah, we're making money, which is good. And it's time for some more construction. Our general, our faction leader can go back there. Right. Our capital, Londinium. Right, so what should we build? Some land clearance there, I think. Here, we have a choice of three temples. One, alright. I thought one did better troops, increasing raidable groups. No. We'll have this one then. First one. Here, they need walls. That is imperative, and here they need walls as well. This guy can build another tower for me. Do not have enough money. Great. Okay, so we have the army here. They have three units there. And one unit in the city. What should I do? Besiege city, I think. Oh, I should have brought my guy in. Never mind. Spawn these guys. Right. Leave my boat there in case I need to retreat. Hopefully that won't happen. Diplomat, continue to head south over some tricky terrain, it seems. There are some like historical like problems with this particular game, like Londinium here. It was built by the Romans, so it wasn't, that wouldn't be here until the Romans actually got there. And the capital of Roman Britain wasn't Londinium, it was Colchester, I think, which was sort of around here, so Londinium was actually a small city. There's also many other problems with it, like you got the country Spain, but Spain didn't exist in the Middle Ages. If it would be a country, it would be called Iberia after the peninsula it was on. But yeah, but it's pretty good gameplay. So back to this particular campaign, end the turn again. Oh, look what's happened. They decided to be brave and attack. Right, it's 7-4. Again, I don't trust the AI. Never trust them. So I'm going to fight the battle. Obviously save. Let's make a... I've already got a backup file, which is good. I can use that one. Right. Well, we could auto-resolve, but no. Let's fight the battle. You want to see some fighting, don't you? I like these quotes, although that one isn't particularly amazing, some of them are pretty good. Famous people from the ancient world. Let's hear this speech.
Today is a grim day for our enemies. They face us. They must know they only have moments left to live.
Oh, one thing, our generals have chariots. Which is pretty cool.
So let your battle cry be death, 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 and shame to our foes.
I think that's it. Right, a special, I thought something that, well, I don't know, some troops have the ability to have war cry, which is sort of just they sort of shouting. But it seems our units don't have that at the moment. Right, let's select all our spearmen. Make them into one group. And these guys, these druids, can probably actually join them as reserves. Missile units, and then we have our chariots, which are cool. Terrain, it looks like they have an advantage, although we're on the defensive, aren't we, so we could probably just come up here and camp on a hill, this nice hill here. Right, group one, there we go, looks cool. Probably use my chariots, sort of go around grabbing them. Yeah, I've got some men in the forest over there. I want to try and... these chariots here that I've currently got selected shoot arrows. My general does not. Oh look, looks like they're squishing all our men, but they won't kill any of them. They just stand back up, which is a bit unrealistic, but whatever. Right, we're going to try and hit some of these rebels. I don't think they have any missile units. I may be mistaken. Right, what do they have? Light infantry, light infantry, light infantry. Druids counted as light infantry, I thought. I thought they were heavy infantry or something. Right, fire. Let's see if they hit anyone. Anyone yet? Doesn't seem like it, does it? Come on, kill someone. Yep, yeah, no. Yep, yeah, one person has died. One guy. Two now. Yeah, they're retreating. It's better to try and kill them at range than we don't lose men. We've lost three men now. It's probably quite boring this first bit, but it's necessary so we don't have lots of casualties. And I can attack these guys now, I think. Run away! Oh, we already killed a few of them. Maybe because we're attacking from the side, they don't have so much armour. Maybe we're just being a bit more lucky. Right, what about their upper army? I think they're just still in the forest. Let's go up to the top here. Oh, bit juddery there. 111 and 116. Let's try and get... Let's see how good these slingers are. We'll put them at like the edge of this hill so they've got the advantage of being higher and they can throw their stones down. Oh, they're just leaving them alone now. Funny. Oh no, they're not. Tell a lie. We are slowly killing them, which is good. Right, now our slingers. Wait a minute, there's a bit of a ridge here. Let's reform these guys a bit. There we go. Stop. Yeah, they can fire now. Fire your stones. Is there anyone? I have no idea. I don't think it did. It was a bit of a fail. But they're going to be surrounded now by these just humongous units. No, they're still chasing our chariots, but chariots can run away easily. Right, you go after the druids. Unit 1, just ram into them. And I know what I'm going to do. Get my unit behind and then flank them. That'll really rout them. No, come here. Alright, they're routed already. Total fail. No, I squished more of our men. Shouldn't really be doing that. Right, you go there. You go there. You go there. You go there. Right, we're just all good.
The enemy warlord shows his worth. Nothing. Any of our warriors would die rather than run.
Right, one unit over here of light infantry again. Group 1, reform please. Our general can chase these routing guys. There you go, dead.
Enemy warlord is dead, slain by your brave
warriors. No, they've come back. For God's sake. They're gonna pay for that. They think that's a good idea. Now you're going to feel the full force of my chariots. That'll probably, yeah, that's routed them. They're just too scared. There you go, squish them. There's the weapon there. But they're doing a good job. 85 they are, slowly getting rid of them. My group 1 just charge in now. It's almost over. Get behind them. Oh, they smashed in there. Yeah, you just watch this now. This will probably make them rout. If it doesn't, I'll be surprised. Right. Oh, don't. They're being squished like hell, though. Well, there we are, losing a few men. I'll probably have to retreat my general out. I don't want to lose him. Nah, they're gone now. Enemy army runs. Now hunt them down. They're still over there. Right, group 1, go over here. We need to finish this last unit off. My general can sort them out. Well, I think we did lose 2 chariots there. Nah, 3. 4, sorry. But, made them rout in the end. Is that... Where's their general? There he is. Kill him. Well, he's not dead from that. He got hit by a chariot. Right, let's get these back over here to lure the enemy. I'll just let him run them over, continue to run them over. Yeah, that's it.
The enemy warlord lies dead. Now he can drink with his ancestors and watch his warriors flee.
Right, come on, unit 1. Time to fly. Let's do some fast forwarding, I think. Play. Double speed, I think. Right. Personally, I think this battle's been a bit of a success, really. We haven't lost many men. Thought I'd lose more, considering how, you know, their experience compared to mine. I know I outnumber them, but sometimes experience can mean everything. And I'm going to end the battle. Yeah, we killed 342, they only killed 76. And our general did the most damage, I think. Yeah. Excellent. Nice music for victory. And we've captured Tara, and they have a green face. I'm going to enslave the populace. You know, you never know what happens. Right, let's retrain these troops. Oh, we can recruit these guys. Woad warriors. They look cool. Not at the moment, though. We haven't got a lot of money at the moment. Oh dear, our ally is spying on us. That's not a good sign. And we have someone coming of age, and he's there in Tara. He needs to travel.
Yes.
Over here. And he can... I can't think of the word now. He can run his own settlement. I not about a spy. Oh, you need to go on the next one. Along with some of these troops after they've retrained. We have construction. A town expands. That needs to be taken care of. Right, almost at the end of this part. Just one more turn, I think. What about our diplomat? Continue to go south. Ooh, that's ghouls. Thought it might have been someone else. Oh, we built our port. Nice. Right, do we have any generals spare for our next invasion, wherever it may be? Seems not. 9-year-old, 13-year-old, 4-year-old. We may not attack anyone yet, we may sort of just prepare. But probably our target will either be Gaul or Germany, obviously. Let's in turn. And it's winter again. And we have a bit of money. Which means... oh dear, look at that. We have some rebel issues. Don't worry, when I send my army across, it should be destroyed. Utterly. Right, let's get the spy on. Actually, I want to send him over, because he's a good general. I want him to lead our armies. He's not even a factionary or faction leader. So what should I keep in here? About 2 units. Well, they're happy with that, only 2 units. Fine. I'm happy with that. So next turn we'll attack them. And what about building? A trader there. A trader there. In Londinium. A trader there. And that city's building. I don't know how you spell that. Say that. Samarobria. No. That was a fail. Right, continue southwards. And another Gallic diplomat. Oh, Tara. We've got Tara, but we can't build anything. Their land clearance is a bit too much. So, let's send our ship down to this port, and we'll probably increase the navy by a few ships. And I think, yeah, that's the end of this part. So, thank you for watching this new LP. I hope it becomes very successful. I hope you enjoy it. And I shall hopefully be doing more episodes next week, along with Troy Total War, obviously. So thank you very much for watching, and I shall see you next time.